My intention is to give you an overview of supply chain best practice. I'm going to combine share and reuse to meet zero waste. So the power of pooling, I've been working in the logistics industry for 10 years. So I've been dealing with a lot of buzzwords, and I would like to move beyond the hype. So if you know the Frog's Dilemma, we are in this change environment where zero waste is a hype and everybody says, let's wait until someone else takes care of that. But actually, if you wait too long, you boil to death. So I think the future runs on reuse, and it's coming from the consumer or the customer. So the shoppers need more, but the planet needs less. It's a very straightforward challenge that we all have, and we need to make it very feasible, and we need to act quite fast. So when we talk about customers at the CHEP environment, we have customers on retailer and producer side, but I would like to give you a little bit of a tease of what's happening in private homes these days. I've been recently testing refill at home, where I don't transport water anymore, but I have a share and reuse system. In the middle, you see a packaging-free aisle on the road, and you have Gorillas, which is delivering my food to the doorstep. So sustainability and zero waste is like an ongoing hype. Another buzzword, the old linear waste model is we make, take, and break things. The new circular model is quite straightforward. You keep it in a loop. So for everyone that doesn't know CHEP, a Brambles company, we operate the largest reusable packaging pool in the world. So you might have seen the blue pallet, but how does a CHEP reuse pooling system works? CHEP provides companies around the globe with pallets. We collect them, we send them, and we make sure that all goods are being transported. We are seen as a hidden champion, but we are quite awarded as a sustainable leader because all our pallets are shared and reused. So as part of the Brambles Group, we are really a global leader when it comes to supply chain solutions. And with this being said, enough marketing on the CHEP brand, but just to give you some scalable figures, it's more than 500 million pallets by now, actually. So we do actually know how to run a reuse system on a scalable, cost-efficient place. So sustainability, where does this fit into the picture? Timber, big topic these days. 100% of our timber comes from forests that we certified, and we also have our own plants in South Africa. Pallets are repaired, reused, and shared. Our network makes the transport quite efficient. So everything we touch goes end to end. We are quite awarded for our core business model. So let's keep in mind what we do today is share and reuse on a pallet basis. But we thought 2 years ago, we need to move beyond the hype. And this is where zero waste world comes into the picture. So let me try to explain in very easy words what we try to do. We hate waste. It's a very simple statement, a very bold statement, and it's not easy to challenge within a year. It does take collaborations. It does take really joint efforts to make a change together. I've seen some very interesting brands in this call that I would really like to connect to, because I do think it requires the retailers, the producers, and the logistics partners to play on the same table. So as a collaboration program, we co-create innovative solutions, but we want to have a positive impact on the planet and the business. So in easy words, we want to do good, but we also want to ideally earn money with it. So we thought, how do we define waste? We want to go towards zero and actually beyond that in packaging waste. So all from primary to secondary packaging. We want to reduce empty miles, that what we call transport waste. And we want to look at the entire supply chain, what we call operational efficiency waste. There we touch a lot on data. So I brought two examples, transport waste, the power of collaboration. Since the last 2 years, more than 200 customers have signed up to our collaborative transport solution system. We saved over $10 million, but also more than 6,000 CO2 emissions avoided. So this is just some KPIs that shows the power of collaboration. Example number two, and problem number one, single use. Go around you, look in your bathroom, look in your kitchen, it's full of waste. So we thought, okay, we are not in the B2C environment, but we as a logistics provider connected to the B2B and the B2C environment, we need to drive the change. We need to bring the parties together. This is a picture from my neighborhood in Cologne. So imagine we travel back to 1950, where unpackaged was a commodity. It was quite common to bring your share and reuse containers to the store. And today it's more complex because in the middle, an industrial revolution happened, right? So we kind of have to turn back in time, but we also have to follow trends. So between the last 70 years, we have the rising trend called packaging free aisle. But to be perfectly honest, they are mainly on the marketing front. They look good. They're unpackaged in store. But what happens in between is far away from being sustainable. So a year ago, my team started the initiative to really collaborate against greenwashing. We want to move more with less together. What does it mean? We are working in the UK and Germany with a wide spectrum of a consortium. And my invitation is come talk to me. We are looking for more innovators to join. And we really want to stop and make the logistics end to end for the reuse. We want to make it sustainable. So our ultimate goal is reuse end to end. We think about the supply chain experience on one side and the customer experience. So I heard the famous words of deposit, return schemes, et cetera. We want to apply our share and reuse competence that we apply for the pallets around the globe. We want to take it further and make share and reuse a commodity. So how to join us? From ideas to research to really concrete trials and scalable solutions, it's an open collaboration program. We find we are so unique in the supply chain, and our knowledge from both retail and producer side makes us a unique champion to apply our knowledge and make it further. So this being said, our vision is clear. With 2025, we have the vision to build the first global regenerative supply chain. We have divided it into different targets. So join our vision. It's really time to act. It's time to make reuse the new black, so to speak. And we hate waste and we want to change, and we invite you to join to move more with less. Thank you very much for your attention.